So, have you ever shopped online? Let's say you're searching for a mobile phone on Amazon. Now, you would have noticed that the site recommends you mobile phones which are in the same price range or by the same brand. Now, if you leave the site without purchasing the product, then you'd be getting ads recommending you to purchase the same product on almost all the websites that you visit. So, how is this really happening? Well, all of this is possible because of machine learning. Now, there are thousands of real-life applications of machine learning which you use on a daily basis, either knowingly or unknowingly. Confused? Well, let's go through some of the examples. So, all of you would have a Gmail account. Now, how do you think Gmail is able to segregate your emails into different folders such as primary, promotions, social, spam, and so on? Or let's say you're sitting on your couch and happily browsing Netflix. So you get a list of movie recommendations which are very similar to your past watch history. So have you ever wondered how is this possible? Does the machine know you personally to suggest movies similar to your interest? And even while driving, Google Maps suggests you which route has more traffic, which route would be faster for you, and how long will it take to reach the destination if you continue on that route. So how do you think Google Maps does this? Well, all of these are just applications of machine learning. Well, all of which arises over here is, what exactly is machine learning? So it's not just about robots. Machine learning is a sub-branch of artificial intelligence which focuses mainly on machines learning from their experience. Let me explain this to you with an analogy. So consider a newly born child who initially knows nothing. So he goes to school to learn. Now, the teacher starts with the alphabets. The teacher shows picture of letter A to the child and tells him it's A. He repeats the process again and again till the student learns all the alphabets. So here the student is being trained. Once the training is complete, teacher conducts a test to verify how well the student has learned. Now, we'll use the same analogy to a machine. So initially we have a machine which knows absolutely nothing. So we start training the machine in a similar way. So the machine has no idea about what is A or what is B. So we start by showing our machine various pictures of the letter A and teaching it that it's A. Once the training is complete, we test the machine by showing it the letter A of different fonts and styles. And if the machine is able to identify the letters accurately, then it means that the machine was trained well. If not, then in order to increase the efficiency, we have to train a machine with more images of A of different fonts and styles and again test it and check its accuracy. So the more training we give, the more accurate our machine would become. So this is the concept of machine learning. Now, machine learning can be broadly classified into three categories. So we have supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. So when it comes to supervised learning, we teach the machine using data which is labeled. Let's say we have a basket of fruits and each fruit is tagged with a label. Now the machine is trained on this label data. So once the training is done, it is given test data or new data to determine how well the training has been done. Now let's take another case where the training data doesn't have any labels associated with it. Here the machine understands the underlying structure of the data to identify similar patterns. And the data which is similar in nature is grouped together. So here the machine understands that all the apples are similar in nature and thus they are grouped together. Same is the case with bananas and mangoes. So this type of machine learning is known as unsupervised learning. And finally we have reinforcement learning, where the algorithm learns through a system of rewards and punishment. Let's say if we feed the machine the image of apple and it labels it as an apple, then it will be rewarded. But on the other hand, if it labels the apple as pineapple, then it'll be given negative points. So the greed of getting more and more reward points lets the machine make thousands of decisions, and this is how the machine is trained.
So this was a brief introduction to machine learning. And if you have any queries, do comment down in the chat section and we'd love to help you out. Also, if you're interested in doing an end-to-end certification course, then IntelliPath provides the Data Science Master's course in association with IBM, where you'll comprehensively learn about data science, machine learning, deep learning, and big data. So you'll work with analytical tools such as R, SAS, and Python, deep learning frameworks such as TensorFlow and Keras, and big data tools such as Hadoop, Spark, and MongoDB. So do call us right now to get started in the field of data science.